40 years, Korea has been under Japanese domination. It's a flourishing, modern country rich in natural resources, and its capital, Seoul, almost more Western than Oriental. Now, the 500,000 Japanese there, soldiers and civilians, are making for home as fast as they can. But they must be processed first, and that means searching for contraband, inoculation, and spraying with DDT. But not too much, or the child will disappear too. Pusan is the popular port 8 or 9 hours from the Japanese homeland. And here, the motley collection of men, women, and children with bags, baskets, and paraphernalia await processing and shipment. There's no luxury about this travel, and no knowing what they'll find in Japan, but they're going, carrying what personal belongings they can. And it looks like every man for himself. I don't know what the journey costs, but there's a ticket for every Jap and clearly marked one way only. Japan once had an empire, but Japanese aggression has proved a vicious boomerang, and the ignominious trek home is on to the land of the setting sun. The great naval base and headquarters of SEAC has gone back to normal or nearly normal, and apart from military vehicles and the uniforms, it's hard to believe that not so long ago, war surged around it and even in it. Singapore, cosmopolis of the East. Malays, Chinese, Indians and British have taken time by the forelock, and the shops and market stalls dazzle the eye and make our mouths water. Oh no, that's a stale joke, we know what those are. But have you money to spend? Singapore will sell you, at a price, everything you can't find in Britain. Hand-painted lanterns might be worth 10 bob, it's yours for a fiver. Undies, cheap at 10 quid. Shoes, only 8 pounds. And flasks and handbags and watches and dress materials galore, and all at a price, but what a price. If you've money to spend, Singapore's got what you want. But remember, it means pounds where it ought to be shillings. An attractive place, but I'll stay where I am.